Let us have an understanding on master worker architecture. In master worker architecture, there will be a master and n number of workers. Maybe for high availability, we can maintain n number of masters as well. Generally, there will be one master and n number of workers keep sending a heartbeat signal to the master saying, I am active and alive. The resources within the workers will be managed by the masters, and master will have a high level information on what are all the resources available and what are all the work happening within the cluster. So the master and worker together, we call it as a cluster. And to manage this master worker architecture or the system hierarchy, we need a resource manager. There are three types of resource manager with which Spark can be made to work. One is Spark standalone resource manager, which comes along with the Spark. So we don't need any external resource manager. Spark itself comes with its own resource manager, where we can designate one machine as a master and all other machine as a worker. And Spark can be deployed or made to work within YARN, that is yet another resource negotiator that is part of Hadoop too. Or we can make it to work as a part of Mesos as well. Mesos is an open source project within Apache. So once the distributed architecture is set up, say I'll be having a master and a number of workers. Let's take an example of a Spark standalone cluster. All the workers will be reporting to the master, and workers will be capable enough to provide an executor to do any task. So each worker, depending on the capacity they have, based on the amount of CPU or RAM or the storage, they can provide the executor, and the work can get distributed or made to work within this executor. Whenever any application gets submitted into the cluster, application will also get executed using master worker architecture. So there will be a master for each application, and n number of work will get spanned within the cluster. So if one application gets submitted, there will be a driver that will get created in any worker, and that's going to act as a master for that specific application. The end-to-end lifecycle of that specific application will be handled by the driver. And driver will have an object to share or to coordinate all the workers. That particular object is called Spark context. That is very specific to the Spark application. And driver will decide how many number of worker tasks required. That many number of worker tasks will get started in various worker machines within the executor. And this coordination will be done by the master, and master will coordinate with the driver in terms of which worker machine is free and who can take up the next work. And simultaneously, if there are n number of jobs getting submitted within the cluster, that many number of driver will get started. In this particular diagram, we have three applications simultaneously running. And so three driver got started. Each driver will have their own Spark context to coordinate. So driver 1, it started two tasks, and driver 2 started one task, and driver 3 started two tasks within various worker machines. And once the job is done, the driver would get terminated, and the results can get collected by various means.